Today on the Comic Book Show, The Nightmare Before Christmas, Cry for Dawn, Chaos Comics, and the Super Secret Celebrity Guest.
Welcome to the Comic Book Show, the coolest TV show about comics, your central authority for cartoons, comic books, and collectibles, and other stuff that doesn't begin with C. Welcome to the show. I'm your host, Tony.
And I'm Nikki.
And this is show number 7.
Let's take a look at the super movie. The super movie is a movie either about superheroes or heroic exploits. Today's super movie is Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas.
This is a thing called a present. The whole thing starts with a box.
A box?
Is it steel?
Are there locks?
Is it filled with a box?
A box? How do you like little box?
If you please. Just a box with bright colored paper. And the whole thing's topped with a bow.
A bow?
But why? How ugly? What's in it?
That's the point of the thing, not to know.
It's a bear!
Will it bend?
It's a rat!
Will it break? Perhaps it's the head that I found in the lake. Listen now, you don't understand. That's not the point of Christmas land.
I enjoyed The Nightmare Before Christmas. I enjoy lots of claymation stuff. I could just watch claymation for hours on end, even if it's just blobs of clay running into each other, which was kind of basically what this movie was. It wasn't much of a plot, although it was beautiful to look at. The songs were really annoying because a lot of the dialogue was just sung. It was like, I'm going across the street to get a cup of coffee, which to me was really unnecessary. I did enjoy Jack the Pumpkin King torturing Santa, and I did enjoy the whole holiday thing, but I think they could have done more with it.
I agree with Tony. Visually, the movie looked fantastic, but those songs, I mean, a good 97% of what they sang in the songs could have been done in dialogue, which would have given better character development and just made the movie a little bit easier to sit through. But overall, it was very entertaining. If Tim Burton decides to do a sequel, I would be there.
Let's rate today's movie, The Nightmare Before Christmas, on the Mighty Meter. The Mighty Meter rates movies from 1 to 5, 5 being mighty good and 1 being mighty lousy. I'm going to rate Nightmare Before Christmas at a 3.5.
I'm also going to give it a 3.5 only because of all those songs.
This week in comics, I'm going to recommend Archer and Armstrong. The story's been really good ever since Mike Barron took over. Mike Barron, of course, did The Badger back a few years ago, and I was a big, big, big fan of The Badger, and I hope they bring The Badger back as well. I'd love to see a Badger, Archer, and Armstrong crossover. Basically, Archer is this kid, the sidekick of Armstrong, who's this big, fat, immortal guy.
Archer and Armstrong is a good book. I think it's one of Valiant's best books, to be honest with you. I also say pick up Wolverine. The last past couple months, the stories have been really cool. It's been taking Wolverine pretty much everywhere across the world. And now Jubilee is a regular, which adds a really neat Marvel style to the whole Batman and Robin dynamic duo type thing.
I really can't get into Wolverine too much. Marvel tries to make him as such a tough guy, such a killer, and yet he never kills anybody. Although I am considering picking it up ever since they removed the metal from his skeleton. Now his claws are made out of bone, which looks kind of interesting. But another title I recommend is Swamp Thing. If you haven't picked this title up in a while, maybe you haven't picked it up since Alan Moore left, you should definitely pick it up now.
Personally, I haven't read Swamp Thing in about 2 years, but I heard the book has improved even more since Vertigo picked it up, which is, of course, the DC imprint. You should also check out X Factor. There's a big noticeable difference since Peter David has left the writing reins of the book, but right now they're focusing on a whole bunch of stories involving the supporting characters, like Polaris and the Multiple Man, who are really good mutant characters that normally don't get any spotlight in the stories whatsoever, and now they finally are.
I really can't stand any of the X titles. I think Marvel has way too many mutants running around. There's like a million mutants and no normal people. But a title that I highly recommend is The Eternal Warrior from Valiant Comics. This is a great book. It's about an immortal guy who basically goes through every war, every fight that has ever been or ever will be. And it's just kind of a fun book. It always starts out with a little bit of history. It has a little bit of story. And he's always involved in something.
Eternal Warrior, I don't know. It's kind of, personally, I think it's a little slow, but that's okay. That's okay, Tony. But something you should check out for a change of pace and some fun is Wonder Man, of course, from Marvel. It's really neat because he's this big spandex-clad superhero who just kind of wanted to give it all up to become an actor in Hollywood with this great acting career, but the supervillains keep coming after him for past vendettas, and he just never seems to get the job done.
Mm-hmm. Wonder Man. They call it Wonder Man because I wonder why people buy this comic. I haven't read Wonder Man since he had the red safari jacket and the sunglasses, but I just have no desire to read Wonder Man anymore. I think he's a silly, silly hero with a silly origin. In case you missed it, pick up Commandees at Earth's End. This is The Boy of Tomorrow meets The Man of Tomorrow. It's a really old Superman meeting one of the old titles, Commandee, in an Elseworlds story that, if you missed it, was 6 issues, and it was pretty good.
You should also backtrack and try to find Superman Speeding Bullets. In my opinion, this is one of the best Elseworlds they ever did. It's this great story in which, like, baby Clark Kent, baby Superman, is actually found by Thomas and Martha Wayne and becomes a super-powered Batman. It's really cool. Tony interviewed the gang over at Cry for Dawn, which, trust me, are a tremendous group. Not only are they talented, but they're some of the most interesting people you'll ever meet. Here's how the interview went.
Tell me, what do you guys, tell us about Cry for Dawn, some of the books it publishes, and what you guys are doing now.
Right now, the two books that we're publishing for, you know, this month, next month, they were pushing are Cry for Dawn and Animal Mystic. Those are our two most solid sellers in the line right now. It's the two most new issues will be coming out in November. Animal Mystic just came out. It's doing well.
Animal Mystic all comes from a series I started way back in 1988. I was 18 years old. Started out Mary as a secondary character. And for some reason, I started focusing on her and created a storyline. And here she is, and it seems to be doing okay.
One of our other books, Exotica, part of it has been taken in for a Fox TV series. It'll be airing in January. It's by Model by Day by Kevin Taylor. We're pushing several of our other titles, which are coming out on a pretty regular basis. Offerings, Danger Funnies, which is by Lance Tooks. He's doing some work for Dark Horse right now on their premiere book for the 40 Acres and the Mule line with Spike Lee's brother. His book is called Danger Funnies. His first published comic work that he'll be doing, and that's with us.
Cry for Dawn, of course, will continue. You have a Cry for Dawn Productions calendar coming up with all the Cry for Dawn guys, as well as Dave Dorman and Lorene Haynes and others. The Cry for Dawn compilation book should finally be coming with a new Colored Dawn story. Animal Mystic will continue. We have Villain and Hero coming out by Joe Heer and Lewis Small of Vampirella. Safety Belt Man is another series that'll be coming in the future.
And what's it like being, a new independent publisher here at the convention against some of these, like, huge, big publishers like DC and Marvel? Do you guys feel intimidated at all, or do you have completely different crowds, or what's the deal?
Since they suck. No, I'm sorry.
No. Pushovers. They all read our book.
They do. All those guys read our stuff, and we don't read theirs.
They know they don't publish anything readable.
Yeah, we've been doing this for about 4 years now. We're not as new as people would think, but we've been noticing from the retailer response that their big problem is, wow, I didn't even see this.
Yeah, what do you think of mainstream comics today? You think they're pretty much crap?
I think it's a joke, and I think what's out there today is, 95% of it's pure crap. Only the good stuff, is the independents.
What's some of the 5% that you like to read and respect?
The main reason I'm in comics is Mr. Richard Corbin, who does Den. I saw my first heavy metal and knew exactly what I wanted to do. Anything from Fanagore, London Knights got some cool stuff.
One of the projects that we're putting together is we have an imprint book with a gentleman who does London Knights Studios, Everett Hartsell. It's an anthology project that's going to get together all the quote-unquote, the outlaws, as we've been described. That's not my term, but people have described it as the outlaws of independent comics. And it's, like I said, it's a 64-page book. It's going to come out at a really reasonable price, like $4.95. We're going to try to replace what Taboo and what Shock System wants to be in the market. A large book of independent creators getting together, doing what they want in their genres, and make it real reasonable for the fans to pick up. We'll be right back.
Hey, where do you race?
Golden Hobbies! Yeah!
Golden Hobbies, the place to race on Aerial Road in Pine Hill. Radio-controlled cars and trucks is just the beginning. Indoor and outdoor tracks, radio-controlled cars and accessories, parts and servicing, weekly races, monthly and annual championships. Bring the family. Golden Hobbies is the place to race. Mention this ad and register to win a radio-controlled car.
Have you called Bill Cole Enterprises yet? Have you? You have not? Well, you better call them, because they make Mylar snugs and comic book preservation supplies. Bill Cole Enterprises, these are the same people that supply the Library of Congress and the National Archives. They don't mess around. They keep the Bill of Rights, the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence fresh. Think of what they could do for your comic books. And not just Mylar snugs, no, no. Acid-free backing boards, boxes, Mylites for every age of comic book. Everything is color-coded, so you don't get confused. Blue for silver and golden age, black for current comics, and even purple for magazines. And now they have Mylar snugs for ash cans. Will you listen to me? Ash cans! Bill Cole Enterprises, available at your local comic book store, or send away for their free catalog of preservation supplies. It's free. You just have to write them a letter. Bill Cole Enterprises, P.O. Box 60, Department CD, Randolph, Massachusetts, 02368-0060. Or to place an order, call 617-986-2653. Bill Cole Enterprises. Ask for them. Ask for them. By name.
DC.
Comics.
Incredible. Action. Astonishing. Adventure. The coolest heroes.
Heroes.
The hottest heroines.
Heroines.
And the most outrageous girl.
Too tough for TV.
In the universe.
These ain't your daddy's comic books, fanboy.
DC Comics.
Available at Marvel Comics in Princeton and New Brunswick.
Welcome back to the comic book show.
In industry news, DC Comics has announced that Mike Carlin, the former editor of Superman, will now be the executive editor of the entire DC universe. And over at Vertigo, their one-time head, Karen Berger, will now be the executive editor of that little sub-universe, which involves all kinds of previous DC characters like Animal Man, Swamp Thing, and John Constantine of Hellblazer, as well as Neil Gaiman's characters like Sandman and Depp. And Marvel Comics are looking for a few good men to fill old knucklehead shoes. That's right, they're looking for people to play Wolverine in their character appearance program. Applicants must be 5'7 to 5'9, weigh 160 to 180 pounds, and be pretty well built, agile, and good working with children. If you are interested in taking a shot at this, what you have to do is write, they ask no phone calls, please, Marvel Comics, Marvel Entertainment Group, 387 Park Avenue South, New York, New York, 10016. And hurry, because the deadline is probably approaching.
Taking a look at brief Tube Watch news, there are 5 brand new episodes of Batman the Animated Series, and if you're looking for them, here are the titles. Shadow of the Bat, Part 1 and 2, The Worry Men, Mudslide, and Call the Crime Doctor. In other news, Gumby is going to have a new movie. Yes, it's going to be called Gumby 1, and Art Clokey, the creator of Gumby, is looking for a distributor. I'm a big fan of Gumby, despite that ugly incident that happened at Comic Fest. Watch out for our interview with the film art curator, the curator of the Gumby Museum, in a future episode. And watch out for the movie, because it's going to have a brand new Gumby character. Basically, they give Gumby a girlfriend. The guys at Chaos Comics, they're a fun bunch of guys. Nikki interviewed them at Comic Fest. Here's the report.
We are here at Comic Fest 93 in Philadelphia, and we are now at the Chaos booth, perhaps one of the coolest booths in the whole darn convention. We're here with Brian Pulido, writer of Evil Ernie, and Stephen Hughes, who is the artist of Evil Ernie. So Brian, tell me a little bit about Chaos Comics.
Well, we decided to form Chaos because we're really pro-creator-owned, and our agenda is to make comics for college-age males and above, cleaner stuff, tougher stuff, that kind of thing. It's a lifestyle. It's an attitude.
What do you guys think Chaos Comics and their products have to offer that other comic book companies don't?
We grew up on comics, and right now in comics, I don't see a lot of stuff that addresses today's readers, the people who grew up with comics. Things like the Ultraverse are pandering. They're not addressing what we want. We're the guys who grew up with Watchmen, Dark Knight Returns. We want tougher stuff. We want high-quality stuff that challenges the reader.
So, Brian, what made you get started in the comics?
I've worked, speaking for myself at least, I worked in the motion picture business and continue to for about 6 or 7 years as an assistant director. I made an Evil Larian screenplay, and very quickly, we had interest from the producers of Hellraiser. But what I noticed was that they made an offer to me and I would immediately get cut out. So what I chose to do was to instead get into comics, develop this thing as a property, and then from a better leveraging position, seek out things like motion picture licenses, etc. What happened was, meeting Stephen Youth through an ad, we wound up just having a blast with comics, so we said, let's go with this. This is the most fun I've had in a long time. I mean, my day job has been incredibly stressful. You know what it's like telling 120 kids what to do at any given time?
Stephen, how did you get started in comics?
I got started out of Canada, actually. I did a job for SL Comics before Malibu ate them up, and it was a book called Stark Future, and I was offered a 2-page backup story. Then the next day they canceled that and offered me the book.
Is the rumor true that Lady Death's breast reduction from an artist standpoint has begun?
Yeah, there's a slight breast reduction going, yeah.
Now, is it true or just a rumor as well? Do you guys have any projects coming up with Dark Horse Comics?
Well, that would be true. Our first project with Dark Horse Comic is called Bracken Pain, and that's a 4-issue miniseries about 2 mean-spirited intergalactic mercenaries. The second one we're doing is called Detonator, Stephen Hughes and I are doing. And it's a revisionist superhero thing. The idea here being is we take an event right here, right now, where people get profound power. And instead of choosing the most obvious people to get the power, we choose probably the least obvious. A woman with a multiple personality disorder, a gangbanger from East LA. The story centers on one guy who feels that he is responsible for the coming of this thing, and he decides he's going to track down all the people with power, hunt them down, and kill them. So it's another happy-go-lucky, fun-spirited book from Chaos.
Okay, that's it for Chaos Comics. Thank you, Brian, and thank you, Steve.
Peace.
Good luck to you guys, and
thank
be
you.
Sure to check these books out. Bye-bye.
Not. Stephanie Anderson.
Kathy Christian.
Bridget Boland.
My name is Tanya Laib.
And you, sir?
Michael Laib.
Said Spawn is Al Simmons. And I went, oh, wonderful.
I am Mantra. I became Mantra from many centuries ago.
Yeah.
And how'd you get this job?
They actually went through a modeling agency in L.A., and they chose me from a selection of girls.
We just fell into it, basically, really.
And how I got into it, actually, Todd was my college roommate.
They searched high and low, and they found me in Los Angeles.
I was kind of the only one who would fit the costume. Mm-hmm.
I didn't get this job. I am Mantra.
Have you ever actually met Adam West?
Yes, I have. Quite a few times. He does know me by name.
The costume is simply great. Who made this?
A lady named Kyra from my hometown, which is in Richland, Washington.
I have contacts in the movie industry.
Uh-huh. You guys collect comic books?
No, actually, I didn't even realize that.
Nope.
Yes, we do.
Is Wildcats your favorite comic of all time?
It's one of the favorite comics, yes.
Do you actually read Vampirella comics?
No.
You have no idea what your character is. You don't know if you shoot rays out of your eyes or what, right?
Actually, I've come to know her.
No, I'm not a big comic fan, but I could see how people would like comics. I'm just not.
Do you like Gumby?
Thing. Gumby, yeah, I do like Gumby, and I'm pretty upset because I wanted to buy a Gumby keychain, and they ran out.
Oh, that's a shame. Gumby can't even get one of his own keychains.
Well, see, I woke up this morning. I had a really bad day. You ever had days like that? Actually, though, this is more of a concept piece. It's like violet hue, you know? The purple hair makes me so debonair.
So do you prefer the Julie Newmar Catwoman or Michelle Pfeiffer Catwoman?
Well...
Do you guys collect cards?
No.
No.
Do you think Vampirella's a tramp?
Any of the other comic book people, would you recognize them if, like, say, I don't know, Stan Lee walked up to you?
No,
probably not.
Don't you know what I am? I'm a man. This body is just a facade. I am actually a man. So...
Could we get a shot of her facade, his facade? Okay, good.
My mind is a man. I think like a man. I act like a man. It's just my outside that's a woman. It's quite a problem, really.
Really? You want to go watch a football game with me later?
Hi, from the Comic Fest, and the comic book show will be right back. For the best selection in mainstream and independent comics, visit the Comic Collection on Bustleton Avenue and Street Road in Feasterville. We have the largest backstock variety in the area, reliable subscription service, used and new compact discs, and a full range of comic-related merchandise. Our courteous staff is available to answer all of your questions. Mention this comic book show ad, and first-time customers receive a free issue of Legends of the Dark Knight. That's the Comic Collection in Feasterville for the serious comic book collector. Hey, where do you race?
Golden Hobbies! Yay!
Golden Hobbies, the place to race on Aerial Road in Pine Hill. Radio-controlled cars and trucks is just the beginning. Indoor and outdoor tracks, radio-controlled cars and accessories, parts and servicing, weekly races, monthly and annual championships. Bring the family. Golden Hobbies is the place to race. Mention this ad and register to win a radio-controlled car.
DC. Incredible. Action. Astonishing. Adventure. The coolest heroes. The hottest heroines. And the most outrageous villains.
Too tough for TV.
In the universe.
These ain't your daddy's comic books, fanboy.
DC Comics.
Available at Marvel Comics in Princeton and New Brunswick.
So all these guys running around in spandex, except the one guy who needs clothing that stretches, the Incredible Hulk. I don't understand why.
Tony, look, you really don't have to walk me to the train.
It's okay, it's only 12 bucks. If he would just wear clothing that stretches.
What was that?
Hey, you okay?
Thank the seven sons you found me. I am Eon, the green beacon of this galaxy sector. I have sacrificed myself in battle to save your primitive yet often invaded planet from a race of evil space decorators who attacked only moments ago.
Why?
They said the blue clashed with the rest of the planet.
No, he meant why did you save us?
There's no time. Take my ring. Its powers are only for those of the pure of heart and righteous of mind. With it, you can travel the spaceways, destroy battlecruisers, and survive in the heart of the sun. The ring will instruct you in its use. You must learn the way of the green beacons if you are to defeat the decorators when they return with the rest of their fleet. Go!
Wow, he's like dead. I guess we should have called 911 during that long soliloquy.
No, he's disintegrating into a blob of protoplasm. Let's go. Need some stupid ring.
Today's lucky letter comes from Jason, who writes, will Marvel Comics ever be restoring the Vision to his old self? Well, actually, Jason, Marvel is halfway through the process right now, so just keep reading the Avengers, because it's going to happen real soon. Tony, what does Jason win for writing us?
Jason wins a signed gold copy of Wild Star number one. It's signed by Jerry Ordway. He's the artist on the book. Also, I'd like to give away a book to John Weber, who wrote us a really nice letter. He really kissed up to us, but he really didn't ask us a question we could answer on the air. So I'm going to send him a signed copy of Secret Weapons number 3, and it's signed by the editor-in-chief and Valiant, Bob Layton. If you would like to kiss up to us, send your letter to TCBS Letters, P.O. Box 10035, Philadelphia, PA 19108. If you send us a letter and we use it on the air, we'll send you something for free. Please include your age and the kind of stuff you like us to send you. Have you called Bill Cole Enterprises yet? Have you? You have not? Well, you better call them, because...
We're here with Harlan Ellison. Welcome to Celebrity Corner. One of the greatest writers, living writers of the 20th century. Is that okay to say?
I suppose I'm one of the great dead writers of the 20th century.
Exactly. We're here to ask him what sort of comic books he likes to read and collect, and what sort of stuff he used to collect when you were a kid.
Well, when I was a kid, I used to collect a lot of dead things. I would find roadkill and save it. Oh, you mean comics?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yes, I see. Well, when I was a kid, I liked Captain Marvel, the real Captain Marvel, the original one. the one who you know, had a great pudenda in his pants there. I also liked Dollman and The Spirit when I was a kid. What I collect now is everything. I have everything because, you see, Marvel Comics ripped me off for one of my stories in an issue of The Hulk, and so in lieu of suing them, they gave me a lot of money plus every one of their products from now till eternity. I get everything. Wow. Marvel sends me everything. I don't have to buy a Marvel comic. They send me the magazines. They send me the epic books. They send me the posters. They send me the buttons, the badges. I got a house full of dreck. It's wonderful. All of this worth a fortune. I have a comic collection that's worth millions of dollars, and no one will ever see it, because when I die, I'm going to set fire to it.
And that's it this week for the Comic Book Show. Tune in next week. We're going to have more comics, more interviews, and we still have more Comic Fest footage. Lots of great interviews we got from that.
Lots more Comic Fest. Mm. So, see you next week.
Goodbye.
See ya.
Culled Enterprises is the exclusive supplier of comic book preservation supplies to the Comic Book Show. Ask for their products by name. And remember, when you go to your local comic store, say you saw it on the Comic Book Show.